Greetings and welcome, fellow horsemen, to another episode of Let's Play Darksiders 3. Alright, so we're on a little bit of a side quest for Vulgrim. Just wanted you to walk onto the thing. So I believe, as long as I've got the flame hollow equipped, I am practically immune to fire. Not immune to death, though. At this rate, it's gonna take a while to get anywhere, but... fighting all of them. Regular whip does not have any charge, that's fine. Alright, now to get in here. Dang it! That triple swing those big guys do is always catching me off guard. Not to mention the annoying shooty ones. I do wish I had a ranged weapon. I mean, I get one later, but... Yeah, I mean, I've never been too keen to play any of these Soulsborne games. just beyond my skill, I believe. Literally not more interested in it with the concept of this constant respawning mechanic in it. But it is a totally fair mechanic, as in you don't lose any of the souls per se, you know, you just have to go get them. And they will always appear in an area where you can get them. Get back here, you. Nope. Alright. And there's still one more, a couple more over on the other side. That look inactive, but might not be. Yep. Yep, that one is active. Yeah, if nothing else, Fury does allow you to vent your frustrations quite adequately with the whip. And the moves also blend together nicely, if they don't actually combo together. Going over there currently has no purpose. You also have to keep an eye out for any hidden goodies. Another Vulgrim spot.
Of this humble merchant.
Yeah, right now, nothing. Let's save up. I want that armor. Enough. Up that out. This thing. Nope. That's a get this back to normal. What does this do again? I know there is a trigger thingy. That doesn't help. Somewhere in these cubes. Nope, dang it. Somewhere in these cubes is a means of getting to the other side of the room. But I think it's currently hidden in the stack. And beyond my reach to activate. So I need to figure out the correct position. Go. Woohoo! Also a neat touch. Fury never really lifts a finger to do anything. He always uses something. But at least this gives us a way back and forth to Vulgrim's spawn point. And there is the boss. And I have no health potions. Yay! Well, I mean, I have the healing stones, but...
Your transgressions are costly. I have slain many of your brethren. If you wish to avoid the same fate, I suggest you talk. Why do you infest the serpent holes? I want answers now! Your silence is disrespectful. Time to teach you some manners. You will fall. I am your man.
Dang it. Yeah, he hits quite hard. But we should at least now have, where is the quick access to get to him. So close. I think I can do this. You know, I'd love to have a little bit more health, but don't have souls to hand in. I have to go make full use of my consumables. If I can get into Devastator mode. Admittedly, I've hoped that'd do a little bit more damage, but... Second phase. I can't turn it off right now. That fist is faster than you think. So close. Can't even purchase anything from Vulgrim because don't have the souls ready being available. Havoc shards. Just have that ready. It'll be useful when we get to the third thing.
I am your end.
it. Nah. The love of sanity. Well, at least the game is not taking pity on me, asking me if I want to bomb down the difficulty. Wish the camera would work with me. So often the camera just keeps getting to the wrong area, so I'm dodging in the wrong direction. Because I get my orientation a little bit off. And with fists flying that fast, that's not generally a good thing. I see that fist coming and I still can't dodge it. Lock on also isn't helping. Come on. Ow. Would you dodge away when I tell you to? This fight can get so frustrating. But that'll have to do for this episode. Thank you all for watching. See you next time. If you enjoy my content, please rate, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all then. Bye!